Leo and Danny show.
This will be good for my Instagram.
It'll be good. That'll be for a lot of things, Johnny, I suppose. Oh, for any kind of club bookings, you can send him that.
Well, I don't know if you guys have been watching my social lately.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to get canceled.
Yeah,
I'm trying my damnedest.
Yeah, you are.
And it's not working, which is, it hurts even more.
Hey, Johnny,
nobody gives a shit.
Johnny, I was hanging out. So my girlfriend has a cousin who's an African-American girl who loves to fuck athletes and rappers.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I was over at her apartment, and I think I'm starting to get on your wavelength that you're talking about, just trying to get canceled, because these rappers, not only am I seeing the music video where the guy's fucking showing his grill, he's showing his 45, he's putting his 45 up the pussy of one of his bitches.
No way.
I'm here. I exaggerated that.
Oh, okay.
But that would be pretty good.
Hearing,
that's pretty awesome.
I'm hearing stories about these guys that they're just running through 10, 15, 20-year-old white girls per night. And I ask my girlfriend, and I ask the girl who fucks all these dudes, are these guys at all concerned about getting canceled, about the Me Too movement? And the girl, Sophia, is like, nah, all they really do is fuck bops. I don't think you can cancel them. And I thought, fucking genius. All they really do is the thing that people get canceled for. Therefore, they can not be canceled.
Right, right. Because that's all they do.
That's all they do. The rapping is not more than 5% of what they do.
Right, right. Well, are they successful rappers?
Yeah.
So they're the last people on earth. Everything that we're not allowed to say and do, as long as it's over a beat, you can still do it.
Right.
Like, yeah. If you go listen to like Migos, or like they're talking about like cooking up dope with an Uzi, mm-hmm. and then you have white girls that have just come from a feminist rally, screaming at the sky, yeah. showing their tits in protest, and they're like, right. "Yeah,
right.
beat that pussy
yeah.
up."
It's the dumbest thing, yeah.
Because they have no respect for black people, really. Mm-hmm. Because if you had respect for people, you would treat everybody equally.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
I get in major beefs with like black comedians and shit, and mm-hmm. they're like, "But aren't you like you're supposed to be Johnny, the cool, you know, hip dude?" I'm like, "Yeah, that's why I treat everybody equal."
Mm-hmm.
You know, because pieces of shit are pieces of shit.
Yeah.
So A, there's that, and B, you know, the music sounds good. So
yeah,
it's rape on.
Yeah, no, I get what you're saying. It's like
JK. JK.
I get what you're saying. It's like the premise of affirmative action, like, is racist.
Absolutely.
It is, you're inferior, therefore we're going to give you help.
Totally. Right.
I get the idea behind it. I just think there are problems in the execution. But also, that's another thing that I was thinking. You're talking about stirring up drugs with Uzis.
That's 15 years minimum. So you have crack plus a firearm.
Yeah.
I just want to point that out.
Mm.
An Israeli firearm, too. That might be imported illegally. But, right. like, I couldn't help but thinking, this is such a bad influence on whoever watches this. Because every music video, at best, blatant materialism was on display.
Right, right.
A guy was showing 90 grand worth of necklaces while posing next to a $300,000 mm-hmm. car. Mm-hmm. Not a great message to get right. out there. Or, at medium, they're dealing drugs.
Right.
A couple of videos just opened with guys cutting up coke, putting marijuana into baggies, and then at absolute worst, they're doing gangsta shit.
Right.
Which is the worst of all influences you could exert on the youth.
Yeah, what do you think the appeal is?
The appeal, because it's a subculture, it's crass materialism celebrated in, you know, communities that have never had shit, and that's traditionally been the only way for like a young black guy from Compton to get money, is through selling drugs and pimping women, which is about as cool as it sounds, if I'm being honest with you. Like, I always wanted, like, I was always enamored of that lifestyle, you know what I mean? I always wanted to be a pimp, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I thought pimping would have been cool, but I can't even get my girlfriend to like fuck me when she's in a bad mood.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Imagine getting 10 women to go have sex with dudes and getting them to give you all of the money.
And as they were alluding to earlier, all their periods would sink because, you know, girls. So imagine just
brilliant.
10. You wouldn't get, like, there'd be a block a week, a month where you couldn't do shit. They were, like, only blowing dudes. Like, it's blowjob week, girls. I got the calendar. It's fucking blowjob week. Get out there. Suck some dick.
Yeah, yeah.
That is a good bit. You should keep that for stand-up.
That's a good stand-up bit.
Their periods sync. It's like Bluetooth. Yeah, everything's synced up.
Dude, that is actually a good bit.